We found the place I saw in my dream. That hill on the shores of Baikal, where Miller took me. A clean place, just like he said. Everything around is clean. We found ourselves a home. A home at the foot of a hill, overlooking a lake. A home where we could raise our children, who will be born not in the damp and dark tunnels, but under blue sky and bright sun. I would say we all go home, but this home seems too large for just us. You know, the Colonel once told me, he created the Order to save people, all of them. I say it's time we perform this duty.
Oh my god, I worked my fucking ass off for this ending. Fuck yeah, let's go. Holy shit. Holy shit, this was so much less frustrating because it was more clear than fucking Last Light. Last Light, you cannot kill anybody. But in this game, you can kill only bad people, which is fine. As long as you don't kill anyone that doesn't deserve it. Oh my god. Oh my god. I had to like walk around it. Because like sometimes it's easy when you're in the heat of battle to just start shooting and shooting and shooting. Like I almost killed some of the tribals in the Caspian section. And I was like freaking out. Thank god I didn't. I like only killed one, I think. And I was like freaking out if Dimir was going to come with me or not. I didn't even know Duke could die. Like literally, I just happened, because I didn't kill any of the cultists, Duke to die. Holy shit, that was such a relief when I got the achievement. Duke survives, I'm like, thank you, God. And then I got the achievement, Dimir comes to you, and I was like, thank you as well. And then Alyosha, like, oh my god, I was a bit nervous with Alyosha, because it wasn't clear if I was like not supposed to knock out people, because I think I only killed like 4 bandits in that entire chapter. I didn't kill a single pirate. I only knocked out pioneers and pirates. That's all I did. And it's like so stressful though, because like they're shooting at you, but you can't do anything. Like you have to basically, I have to like go ramble them and like run at them and like Muhammad Ali them. Like oh my god. Oh my god, man. Like. But oh my god, I'm so happy I got the good ending. Like, holy shit. I worked my ass off, man. I fucking love this game series. I bought this game 4 or 5 years ago, like around the time it came out. I didn't buy it on launch, maybe like a couple months after, 6 months. I got it on sale, so maybe like a year. Okay, maybe, but anyways, I bought this game, and oh my god, man. I am so happy that I finally finished it. I actually went back and played Metro 2033 and both Last Light. I got both endings for 2033. Fucking Last Light, I got the bad ending. I'm gonna go back and get the good ending because that's the canonical ending. But like, dude, I did my best to get the good ending with what I knew of, and I didn't get it just because I killed too many bad people that were shooting at me. So like you're literally supposed to not kill anyone in that game, which is not fun at all. That is not fun. And I really hope hold on, I'm trying to remember what the studio's name is. 4-3 Studios? 4-8 Studios. I really hope they will keep going in the direction that they took this game, but I also want them to add more lethal options. I mean non-lethal options. Range non-lethal options. If you're gonna punish us for killing someone that's shooting us, because that is not fun. It is not fun if you can't do anything and your only way of taking them out is rushing a group of them, where you will most likely die, by the way, because there's like a bunch of them, and just like knocking them out. So please add in like tranquilizer rounds, tranquilizer guns, just ranged non-lethal routes for the next game, like how Metal Gear Solid does. Like, that is all I'm asking for the next Metro game. If you insist that we cannot fight back with anyone, like, okay, listen, take example, the pirates. I'm not saying you get good karma just for like killing them all. No. Because I like that you just can't just ramble it, because like that's not fun. Just rambling everything is like, oh, then it's like no consequences. No. I'm saying, if you're not gonna give us like ranged, non-lethal ways to knock out people or to like subdue them, then you should not. Okay, the moment they fire on you, I feel like it should be changed where you no longer get negative morale points for killing them, because at that point it's self-defense. So, like, either give us non-lethal ranged options, or just make it when they start shooting at you, it no longer counts as a negative point. because that can be very frustrating sometimes, especially if you're like stuck in a room and it's like a wide open area with no cover. You can't run. Like I nearly died a few times at the airstrip in the Caspian border because a bunch of tribals showed up, and you can't kill tribals even if they're shooting at you. And I was stuck in a shed. They had like it surrounded, so I had to like sprint. I had to like haul ass, pop so many medkits, and waste so many resources just so I could get them. And thank God, upstairs where the shambler is, I could take a zipline, which pretty much like negated them, and I could just get in the car and just drive away. But still, like, that was not fun. Like, I still enjoyed the game overall, especially the Yamantau of cannibals, because I was like so stressed, like, oh my god, do I not kill these people? But thankfully, like, you don't get karma for killing them, which makes sense. But please, add range non-lethal options, or just make it with the moment they start firing, it's self-defense and no repercussions, because sometimes that can be really frustrating. But for the most part, I really enjoyed my time with here, like the story, and it felt so fucking rewarding because this is my first full playthrough of the game that I got the good ending with and the full strength achievement on my first try of the game, so that makes me very happy. Yeah, with that being said, oh my god, I can't wait for the next Metro, mainline Metro game. I know Metro Awakening is happening, but that's a VR game and I don't have VR, so I'll probably watch a walkthrough on that, but I can't wait for them to cook up what they got cooking for the next mainline Metro game. And I really hope that they will implement the things that I asked. But yeah, with that being said, take care, ladies and gentlemen, and goodbye.